3 million years ago, the light at the end of the tunnel can be seen. Changing times require a changing lifestyle, but the indecisive Arborobauria just doesn't know what it wants to do. Bauria's wish guarantees that it and its descendants will have ruined this planet, but there has to be a greater purpose for all of this, right? And the best way to find it is to divide and conquer. So Arborobauria split herself into two halves, each half embodying the potential once held within her. Both of these halves will be known as Neobauria, a name with identical meaning to the halves of now long gone Novabauria, but for different reasons. One of these halves will be the swift half, Neobauria gracilis. A speedy, skinny, low-slung beast, it relied on its agility and venom in order to tackle even the fastest of prey. Arborobauria's nimble nature. The other half was a strong half, Neobauria felinox. Its legs were longer and its body much more muscular. Its venom was weak, but with its hunting style, it didn't need venom. Arborobauria's ability to grapple and brawl. Collectively, they're known as the Ophaurs. They each had their strengths and weaknesses, benefits and drawbacks, and they lived in different, yet nearby areas. Life went on. It is important to note, even with Bauria's wish, the Baurias are not above the ecosystem. Their population can still decline and even disappear from areas. They are still affected by disease, predators, and competition. Our swift Neobauria is an efficient predator, but it is a weak and fragile animal. Nearly any opponent will have an easy time bullying and stealing food from them. They are venomous, but they aren't built to fight and can be easily killed before landing any attack. They also have trouble against defending their nests against large predators for this reason. Many have seen a huge portion of their clutches consumed without a second thought. Even if they lay enough eggs to ensure the survival of at least a few, it hurts. Our strong Neobauria is great at hunting large prey, but the thing is, it's slow. It is bulky and far less conservative than the carnivores it has to contend with. They are able to defend their kills, but if they stray too far while defending, it can be taken from right under their nose. They lay less eggs and aren't as good of diggers, but can scare off most egg stealers. However, taking a single egg of this species has a similar effect to taking multiple eggs of the other Ophaur. Even if we just lose one egg, one baby, it hurts. Eventually, after countless losses, it slowly constricted the range of both species, and they finally crossed paths. The Ophaur were different enough in lifestyle that they didn't compete. They coexisted peacefully, but they couldn't stay separate for long. They are more genetically similar than one would expect. They can mix their genes to create offspring that's often fertile. Their potential size difference didn't matter too much due to how they mate. And since they both be outclassed like other predators otherwise, they only had one option. So two halves came together once more. And the result? A creature with the best of both worlds. A body powerful, but also flexible and agile. Things that are strong enough to kill on their own, but can be enhanced with a hint of venom if needed. A mother that can lay lots of eggs and defend them all. A mother that remembers what happened to her mother's offspring, and her mother's mother's offspring, and that refuses to let that happen. Not again. Not without paying the highest price. Not exactly their parents, but not exactly their own species. These hybrids are more than the sum of their parts. And the only step left to a truly perfect union is... time.